So golfers will sometimes struggle hitting long shots into par fours, par fives, or even the first shot on long par threes. It might require them to hit their longest iron or even a hybrid. In this video, I'm going to show you the best techniques to hitting your long iron and the best techniques to hitting your hybrids. So let's talk about the differences first with a long iron and a hybrid. Typically, a long iron is more suited to golfers who swing it faster. Because there's less club head behind the golf ball, it's harder to easily pop the ball up in the air. That's why club head speed is important. Now, for slower swing speeds, hybrids are really valuable because the size of the head and the way it's shaped actually helps the golf ball go up in the air a lot more. And typically, because of that, hybrids will go higher. Even though I've both got these in a four iron setting, four iron loft, so to speak, the hybrid will typically go higher. And that's suited to different golfers. It depends on what type of golf course you play. Playing that higher shot might be more valuable. I'm going to show you with irons first. So as I mentioned, irons need slightly faster clubhead speed. If you struggle with an iron, it might be worth looking into a hybrid. But I'm going to show you how to hit an iron anyway. The first thing is, what we've got to look for is we've got to change the setup slightly just to give us the best advantage to allow this club to do its job. To do that, we're looking for ball position just to be more in front of center, almost underneath my left pec, so that I'm going to be able to make a clean contact. With a four iron or a long iron, we don't want to be hitting down on the golf ball a lot. As soon as you start hitting down on the golf ball too much, you're going to take a massive divot, and that's not going to help you get the right flight that you need with the four iron. So first thing, having that ball position just slightly more underneath the left pec. And then all you're looking here is have the sternum slightly over the club head. Because with a four iron, we don't want to hit up on the golf ball. We don't want to be leaning back, because as soon as you start hitting that ground behind the golf ball, like any iron shot, it's going to dig in. That front edge of the golf club is going to dig into the ground, and you're just going to fat it in front of you. See, many golfers do that with an iron. Because the temptation, and I completely get it, the temptation with a long iron, because you look down at it, and there's not a lot of loft on the head, instantly you want to try and get the ball up in the air. Avoid that. If you're trying to get the ball up in the air with a four iron, you're struggling. You're better off to go with a hybrid, believe me. So, ball position just in front of center, more underneath the left pec, sternum more over the club head, and all we're looking to do here is we are wanting to hit down slightly and take a tiny little divot. Bruise the ground. That's all we're looking to do here. If you hit it clean, that's not a bad thing either. If you can catch a long iron clean with speed, you'll get the desired flight you're looking for. You see there, I mean, that is a good golf shot with a four iron, and I have literally bruised the surface. In fact, if you come in close, let me show you this. That's where the ball was, and there's no divot. I mean, it's very, very clean. You can hit a slightly more, you can take a little bit more ground than that, but I would not be looking for a big chunky divot with a four iron. Unless you've got tremendous speed. That's the only time you could hit a little bit more of a divot, but that's talking about the tiniest amount of people who can swing that fast. So that's four iron. Comes out a bit flatter, comes out quite flat. I like hitting my four irons. I'm a big fan of them, but I've got the club head speed to be able to do it. If you've not, hybrids are an unbelievable club. They got introduced years ago, really as a club to help you escape rough or hazards. But now they've become an integral part for a lot of golfers' bags. Even the best players in the world are putting hybrids in the bags a lot more. As I mentioned, because of the shape of the head, because there's more mass behind the club head, it is easier to pop the golf ball up in the air. It gives you a little bit more leeway. Now with a hybrid, we can hit more level, and actually you can slightly hit up on the golf ball. So for those golfers who get a little bit guilty of leaning back and trying to lift the ball with their long clubs, a hybrid gives you that little bit of protection because it's got more of a flat bottom. It's not going to dig into the ground as much. So what I look for with hybrid is something similar. Ball position, similar to four iron, but this time having the sternum just more towards the back of the head. I've got a tiny bit of a tilt in the body. And all I'm looking for here is to sweep the golf ball. You can hit slightly up, but more just trying to hit level. Again, we're not trying to take a massive divot. So if I just slightly try and sweep the golf ball away this time, straight away the flight is totally different, much higher. Again, I've not taken a massive divot from the ground and the ball will pop up. The luxury of a hybrid, I'm going to show you a shot here, the luxury of a hybrid, if I just stay back on it a little bit too much, if I incorrectly keep my weight too far on my right foot and hit the ground behind the golf ball, the ball still pops up in the air. It's a massive safety net with the shape of a hybrid, just because of the bottom of the golf club. It gives you that little bit of a luxury. If you do hit the ground, it's not going to dig in. That's how you hit your long irons, that's how you hit your hybrids, and that's how you're going to reach those par fours, par fives easier, and those really tough par threes. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.